The true history of the Valldemossa episode seems to be that Chopin, a sincere Catholic, was frightened by Solange, not into going away, as she hoped, but into confessing his sins to the sole remaining Carthusian priest at the monastery, the old pharmacist. He was then granted absolution on an undertaking to break his physical relations with George, and afterwards promised her not to marry or live with anyone else if she remained equally true to him. This bargain she is known to have kept. But 7 years later, Solange, for spite, told Chopin that her mother had secretly taken a new lover. Chopin believed the lie, yet he still loved her and died, whispering reproachfully, "She promised I would die in her arms." Chopin's abiding affection for Majorca, to which his friends testified, was apparently bound up with the memory of his regeneration. George's hatred of Majorca was bound up with a memory of her defeat at the hands of the church. Unwilling to tell the truth, she vented her feelings on the Majorcan peasants in the intemperate and libelous winter in Majorca, calling them rogues, oafs, filthy monkeys, cannibals, monks, bastards, hypocrites. "Well, Majorca has been my home for 25 years. I can say that if there is a kinder, friendlier, cleaner, or more honest people in Europe than the Majorcans, I have not yet met them. And from all accounts, they were no worse in 1838. That was written by Robert Graves in Dea, 1955. Let me just put this down for a minute. And here is my version of it. By Delacroix, is that an original? I think that was a highly romanticized depiction of his death. Day is it?
Sorry. Now, I think this is where Wanda Landowska posed for a photograph from 1911. There she is. It can only be there, I think, because that wall is different. That's all kind of looks the same, even those are the bench there. I think she's sitting, her head's just above the top of that, and this picture would have been taken from where I'm standing, I think. Anyway, I don't know where else it could be. of little fishies. There was a bigger one yesterday, like a big goldfish. I'm not sure of the significance of that. Let's have a final look at the view. Cypress trees, worthy of Van Gogh. This is very much overgrown compared to the photograph in my 1961 book, which you can see all the stonework in it. Really, this is very much overgrown, which is nice. Oh, it's nice. I like it. There's just one other place I want to go to see Chopin's lock of hair. And his waistcoat. Which is in the other room. I don't think I could pay extra for that. We did yesterday. We paid for the, we could see the whole monastery, which is huge. Okay, Rosa, where is have the Chopin's lock of hair and his waistcoat? Is that, you know, there's lock of hair and his waistcoat? There's Chopin, yeah, is it? It's just that one.
Number two. Exposition Chopin, but other ticket, please.
Oh, it's the other ticket.
Not included.
All right, then.
It's two different tickets.
Oh, right, okay, it's what I did yesterday. Okay, thank you. All right, then. Ciao. Okay, this is part two of my little tour. We need the other ticket to go and see the other bit with his waistcoat, and it's in cell number two. Let's just have a quick look. This is the way out anyway. Okay. Two huge statues, Chopin and George Sand. Okay, I'm going to switch this off.